All day. Welcome to episode 1.6 of Lock It In, presented by All Day Media. I'm your host, Bam. We've got Cobbs live and remote from Charlotte, North Carolina. And to my left is DC, Dylan Clark. How we doing today, boys?
I'm feeling immaculate.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, baby. We're feeling immaculate. The immaculate teaser. It was immaculate once again. We went 6-3 as a show. Following up 2 weeks ago, we went 7-2. I mean, we are sizzling hot in these last 2 weeks. And if you're subscribed to this show, which you definitely should be, you are definitely having a profitable NFL season so far, which is all you can ask for. So like and subscribe to the YouTube. Follow us on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. You're definitely having a profitable NFL season if you're tailing us, but we definitely maybe know what we're talking about in a sense. So what did you learn, definitely maybe, from week 5, Cobbs?
Yeah, so I'm going to say this is definitely maybe a turning point of the season. It's past the quarter point. The math's kind of weird now. There's 17 games, but this is the part of the season. Get Scott Hansen. It's the witching hour. The teams that are shitty are going to show their frauds, and the teams that are actually good are going to rise to the top. You know, we talked about it before. Bengals slow start ended up in the AFC Championship last year. They kind of got back on track last week. I think we're going to see a lot of shaking up just around the league and the divisions and everything with injuries coming up. I mean, the IR, I think, was the big story of this morning. A lot of guys going down. So we're going to see a lot of true colors in this next month here and see who's playing some meaningful football in November and December.
Yeah. After 5 weeks, we're finally seeing which teams are good and which teams are bad. And which teams are showing their true colors.
But speaking of showing the true colors, I think the Falcons have definitely maybe shown they're a playoff team.
Playoffs? Don't talk about it. Playoffs? You kidding me?
Wow.
After this next week coming up against Washington, they don't play another team that is in the top 20 of total offensive yards. They have a pretty good defense, and their passing weapons have really yet to be used yet. And debatably, I think Bijan really hasn't even been used yet. You know, they've been leaning on Algier. I think the offense is a lot to be seen, and I think the defense is good enough against the schedule they have coming up that they'll be in the playoffs. They'll be firmly entrenched in the playoff race.
Wow. I would have disagreed with you 100% before looking at their schedule, and the Falcons definitely maybe have the easiest schedule of the NFL at this point.
It is incredibly easy.
Wow.
Yeah, a weak division and an even weaker schedule down the stretch. I could see a 9-8 wild card maybe.
That's a hot take and a half there, Clark. I like it. I definitely maybe think that we should have paid more attention to the international travel schedule when it comes to the London games. So the Bills got into London on Friday night. I mean, there was a 5-hour time difference. They basically had one day to acclimate to the time change and the London atmosphere, everything that's going on in literally a different country. Meanwhile, the Jaguars, they had been there for over a week. I think Jacksonville had like an unprecedented home field advantage at that point. There's one game this week in overseas. I think they play in London again. It's the Ravens versus the Titans. And there's two games in November in Germany. So definitely maybe pay attention to the travel schedule if you're going to be betting on the international series. So we had a fantastic week last week. Cobbs, you went 3-0 last week. What do you say we go 1-0 on the picks that you like?
Yeah, so I like the Colts +4 against the Jaguars. I think we seem to have been saying a lot of nice things about the Colts on this show.
Yeah, we have.
And for good reason. And the Colts are, you know, maybe you didn't expect them to be that good this year, but, you know, the story last week, it wasn't Anthony Richardson's injury. It wasn't the return of Jonathan Taylor. It was Zach Moss running for 165 yards and 2 touchdowns. They're just kind of a weird team, and the AFC South is a weird division. And if you look, I was looking this earlier, this Jags-Colts matchup since 2018, every season has been a split. The Jaguars won in week one by 10, but I've been saying it since the summer. The Jags, they're young and they're talented, but they're still a little bit fraudulent. I don't think they're contenders or anything. They've won some nice games, but the scores have not done it justice. I think they've been playing sloppy football. Trevor's really just not on his game so far this season. I think getting the Colts +4 is just too much value to not take. You're getting more than a field goal. Maybe they'll lose, but I think it'll be very close. I'll take the Colts +4 all day.
Yeah, I like that, especially with a divisional matchup, like giving the Colts 4 points. How can you not like that? And you get Jonathan Taylor back. I mean, Colts +4, looking pretty good. Clark, what do you like?
Yeah, I like the under in the Pats-Raiders game this week.
Oh, that's such a stinky game.
Yeah, it's at 41.5. That's why I like the under so much. both two good defenses. The offenses, you know, leaving something to be desired. The Davante Adams being injured, I don't think they're going to be trying to scheme the ball to him as much. Jacoby Myers is good, and they have not really got Josh Jacobs going whatsoever. The Pats, I mean, I'm pretty sure Mac Jones is losing his job.
Yeah, he's been benched 2 weeks in a row.
And I don't think Ramondre has broke 45 yards rushing. So I don't like either of these offenses, but I do like both defenses, and I think under 41.5 is pretty easy. So I like it. I like it a lot.
Is that a Jacoby Myers revenge game, or is it a Patriots revenge game against Jacoby Myers?
See, I was thinking that it's a Bill Belichick revenge game against Josh McDaniels.
There's a lot of storylines going on in that game.
It's a revenge game.
This game's going to be a mess, and I think that it's going to be Sophie's choice of who's going to score the touchdown. I don't think there's going to be a lot scored.
Yeah, so, 7-3 final score. There's no points in this game. It's a revenge. There's 0 points. So I like that a lot.
Someone's getting revenge.
Okay.
But we don't know who.
Under 41.5 for the Patriots Raiders. I like that. I really do. Those are two terrible offenses. I like the Falcons -2.5. And with your stat earlier, the Falcons, I was never on their train this year, but Desmond Ridder is 31-0 at home since college. So the dude wins at home. They're at home this week against the Commanders. Ron Rivera looks like he wants to get fired with some of these coaching decisions that he's making.
Yeah.
The Commanders, I mean, Khalil Herbert got injured in the first half, but I mean, he was on pace for probably a record-breaking game. They let Khalil Herbert run all over them with a one-dimensional Bears offense, and I think Bijan Robinson's going to have a day for Atlanta. The Falcons are just different at home, and if it comes down to a field goal, Younghoe Koo is absolutely automatic, so give me 2.5. Also, I'm just going to get out ahead of this right now. If Younghoe Koo does happen to miss a game-winning field goal to not cover the spread, that just shows how much I know ball. And the football gods, they're humbling me a little bit because I literally called the Younghoe Koo to cover 2.5. Just saying. So we like the Colts. We like the under in the stinky revenge game. And I like the Falcons -2.5. But what do you love, Cobbs?
I love the Saints -1.5. Call back to what I was just saying earlier. I think the Saints are one of those teams. I think they're kind of a good team finding their way. I think they were very disrespected coming into the season, but they have an excellent defense. They're top five in almost every single defensive stat that you could imagine. They've got Alvin back now. Their receiving core has stayed healthy. Yes, even Michael Thomas. And I think Derek Carr is serviceable. You know, the Stroud boys, they're standing back. They're standing by. And I do like the Texans, but I love the Saints. I think the Texans are a good team, but I think they're a young team, and I just don't think it's enough points. I think the Saints are a better team, and you're getting them at essentially a pick 'em coming off a 34-0 victory over Belichick in Foxborough. I just think they're going to win this by at least a field goal. It might be a decent game, but the Saints are winning this one. Give me the Saints all day.
Yeah, they looked really good against the Patriots. And just to be clear, this podcast, we are pro CJ Stroud.
Oh, we are. Yeah. We're
big time. Rookie of the year.
We're Straw Boys.
We are pro CJ Straw. We're Straw Boys on this podcast. Yeah. So you love the Saints -1.5. Okay. Clark, what do you love?
You know, we're doing a little bit of a science experiment today.
Mm.
I have yet to win a single love it pick.
Ooh.
And what better way to test it than to put the best team to the test? I love the Niners -5.5 against the Browns. The Browns have Deshaun with a bum-ass shoulder. No Nick Chubb.
Minimal Chubb.
Coming off a bye, so, you know, they could have some rest, but at the same time, they, you know, could be a little rusty. And the Niners are just the premier juggernaut of the league.
Dude, the Niners are unstoppable.
Who's going to stop that team? The Browns' defense is pretty good, but if I were to put both teams on a scale, I would say the Niners' weapons outweigh the Browns' weapons.
That's a fact.
And the defenses, you know, it's called a wash. The Niners have it.
This guy is due for a love it pick. The only thing that scares me, though, is it's in Cleveland. It could be like a rainy, cold, like messy game, but the Niners are so damn good.
Yeah,
5.5 is a low number.
I was going to say that I don't know what's stopping the Niners, and no offense, Clark, but I hope we're jinxing them right now because I don't know how they're going to lose a game. Either way, we're winners. You're going to hit the pick, or the Niners are finally going to lose, and the Lions might be tied for first in the NFC. So.
We'll see.
Speaking of the Lions, we all love the Lions, but I, this week especially, love the Lions to cover. I love the Lions -3.5 against the Buccaneers. The Lions have covered in every away game that they've played this year, including at Kansas City against the reigning Super Bowl champs. I think the momentum is going in the right direction for this Detroit team, and it's a very hot Lions team going into Tampa Bay off of a bye. It's the classic rust versus rest debate. I think Tampa might be a little bit rusty. They're 3-1, but they've played some pretty bad teams so far, and they got killed against the Eagles at home, so I think this is another test against a legit team in Tampa Bay. I think the Lions show that they're right up there with Philly and San Francisco atop the NFC, and I think they cover big against this overrated Bucs team.
Yeah, teams showing their true colors. The Buccaneers were a team I was referencing. I think they're going to start falling off of this 3-1.
They should not be 3-1. I mean, they are, but they should not be 3-1. They're not 3-1 good.
They're not 3-1 good, but they're not bad. I like them.
Well, I love the Lions -3.5. You love the Niners -5.5. Cobbs is a Stroud boy, but he loves the Saints. We liked it. We loved it. And now it is time to lock it in. What are you locking in this week, Jacobs?
Well, the mighty have fallen. Every team has now lost against the spread, with the Los Angeles Rams not covering last week. I'm going to take the bounce back this week. I'm locking in the Rams -6.5 against the Cardinals. The Cardinals have been like this darling team because they're not as bad as we all thought they were going to be. And now people are like afraid to bet against them. But I trusted the eye test last week. I'm going to trust it again this week. Cooper Kupp back in the Rams offense. Did not miss a beat. And more importantly, Puka Nacua did not miss a beat in the Rams offense. The Cardinals are horrible against the pass, 26 in the league against the pass. Their entire defense just ranks, I think, near bottom five in almost every statistic. I think the Rams are going to win this one by at least a touchdown, probably by 10. It's a home divisional game. I'm locking in the Rams.
I think the Cardinals have finally come down to earth after being a very scrappy team. And you're right. I mean, getting Cooper Kupp back, Puka Nacua is still a very elite weapon in that offense. So now Stafford just has another weapon to throw to. Clark, what are you locking in?
I'm going on the shoulders of Cobbs.
Oh, baby.
We're locking in the Rams. -6.5. This is the first time that you and I haven't had some kind of a controversy, I believe.
No controversy here.
Yeah. The Rams are going to roll.
You heard it here first.
It's a guarantee right here. it really is.
Coming from somebody that went 0-3 last week.
You know, yeah. So take it with a grain of salt, but I might be due. Once you add Cooper Kupp into this Rams offense, Matt Stafford is instantly able to throw for more than one passing touchdown in a game. Is that a coincidence? I think not.
Nope.
I think the defense still looks fine. I think the Rams are going to be able to take care of business and at least win by a touchdown pretty easily.
Wow. We've got no controversy. We've got some tailing on the picks for the lock it in. That seems a bit juicy. Rams -6.5 might be the play of the week. We'll have to see how that turns out. I hope they absolutely kill them. I believe it's at SoFi Stadium as well, right?
Yeah, they're at home.
Rams at home -6.5, locking that in. I'm locking in a pick that I am so excited to see hit, and it's something that when you bet on something you're so confident about and it's a fun bet, you just love watching the game. I am locking in the over in the Cowboys at Chargers on Monday Night Football. I think this is going to be an absolute shootout. The Cowboys defense is banged up. It's at 49.5 right now. They just gave up 42 to San Francisco in California in primetime. You know what else is in California in primetime? Monday Night Football. The Cowboys go to SoFi Stadium. They put up 10 points against the 49ers defense, and I can only imagine how many points they're going to put up against Brandon Staley's defense. Again, I'm calling my shot here. I think that, hopefully this doesn't bite me in the ass, but I think that this game is going to be an absolute shootout, projecting like 35-30, and Dak throws a interception late in the game to end up losing it for the Cowboys. So I think the Chargers cover, but I love over 49.5. I'm locking it in.
Yeah, I think this might finally be that primetime game we've all been waiting for, like what we thought we were going to get from Cowboys-Niners last week. But
seriously,
it seems the last, I don't know, handful of years, the Chargers in primetime have just had this like flair for the dramatic. It's always been these really exciting down-to-the-wire games. I feel like they're usually like Raiders or Chiefs. Yeah, Chargers-Raiders have been crazy.
The Chargers are an exciting team to watch, and on Monday Night Football against a Cowboys team with a chip on their shoulder, there's going to be points.
Yeah, and it's it's a mess of a coaching matchup. I mean, you got McCarthy and Staley. I mean, both these guys might not be head coaches next season.
Well, we liked it and we loved it and we locked it in, and I'm so excited for those picks. We're going 8-0. You heard it here first. But now it's time for the real moneymaker of the show. We're going to get immaculate, and we're going with our immaculate teaser. It won last week. It won the week prior. It is now 3-1 on the season, and this teaser will not lose. This is a teaser that you can throw the bank on. The immaculate teaser is brought to you by All Day Media. We're going 4-1 on the immaculate teaser. What do you got for your teaser pick that definitely will not lose, Jacobs?
Yeah, so I'm going to kind of contradict what I just said, but I'm going to tease the San Francisco 49ers. As of right now, it'll get you down to +1.5. And what'd you say? This can't lose, right? And like I just said, if it loses, then we get a loss from the Niners, which I think everyone would like to see because they look unstoppable. But like I just said, they look unstoppable. I think there's no way that they lose. Deshaun Watson might not play as of right now. They're saying that the replacement will be PJ Walker, who is kind of an X factor, but the Niners are just too good. You know, the spread might be tough, but they're winning this game. It's the immaculate teaser. Don't think about it too much. Don't sweat it. The Niners are getting the dub.
I agree. Don't think about it too much. This is basically just Niners money line. The 49ers have to beat the Browns for the immaculate teaser. That sounds pretty immaculate, I'd say.
It's easier than that. They can lose by a point.
Yeah, I'd say that'll do. Clark,
you want to know what's easier than that?
What is easier than the Niners money
line? It's teasing the Chargers the +8.5.
I love it.
It is two high-powered offenses. We all think the Cowboys' defense is elite, and it does look it looks pretty good.
Leighton Van Der Esch out. Trayvon Diggs out.
A little banged up.
Yeah.
A little banged up. What I do like about the Chargers is they're adding Austin Eckler back for the first time since week one.
Thank God.
And even though Mike Williams went down, it is a thing after the bye week for teams to start scheming in their rookies. And I think with Mike Williams getting injured, I think they're going to find a way to get Quentin Johnson involved in the game script. So I think this Chargers offense is not going to miss a beat. Kellen Moore just whizzing up some crazy things happening on our TV screens. That's what he does. That's what he does, and I love the Chargers, honestly, to win the game outright, but +8.5, I think it's just can't miss.
I feel like the Chargers are one of those teams, too. Like, last year, the Vikings, they were 11-0 in one-score games. Like, the Chargers will not get blown out. If anything, they'll keep it close. I think they win the game, too, but +8.5, that ain't losing.
No. You're getting a touchdown and then some. So.
Yeah.
Yeah,
That's immaculate. And the other pick, as I'm looking at this slate, and I'm thinking to myself, what is impossible to lose? The Dolphins -8 is impossible to lose. They're playing the Panthers. Fade the Panthers. I mean, Bryce Young, we said it last week, he looked like Helen Keller out there at Ford Field. They're going down to Miami. It's a big number, but the Dolphins have showed that they can absolutely cover a big spread. They beat the Giants by 15 in Miami last week. I think the Panthers are equally bad. Tua continues to dominate as a home favorite. He's 6-1 against the spread in his last 7. And I think he made some mistakes last week, but like they should have blown out the Giants by even more. He threw that one pick 6 to James Pinnock when they were in the red zone. If they didn't do that, the Dolphins win by 20+. So for
What I was going to say. Like, they blew them out way more than by 15.
Oh,
to be
way
honest.
More than the scoreboard showed. So for them to win by 8 against the Panthers, that is a absolute winner. And if you take the immaculate teaser, you're going to make money. There's no other way to say it.
It's +130 win every week.
The immaculate teaser is brought to you by All Day Media. Make sure that you go ahead and like and subscribe to the YouTube. Follow us on Instagram and TikTok. We have big things coming, so make sure to stay tuned to that. We're going to wrap up the show by getting propalicious and choosing an anytime touchdown scorer. My main man, DC, to my left, he is propalicious himself, and you may have went 0-3 last week on your picks, but your touchdown scorer, Ja'Marr Chase, scored 3 touchdowns, so this guy's hot when it comes to anytime touchdowns. I would like to hear what you've got this week for your anytime touchdown scorer.
Yeah, I'm going back to another wide receiver one. I'm taking Stephon Diggs, anytime touchdown scorer.
Okay.
It seems like Josh Allen and Stephon are on the same page. They're playing against the Giants. Whether we have a surprise game script and the Giants go up early, Josh Allen's going to have to find Stephon. Or if they're just going up early, You know, and let's say this is the score that puts them up 14-0, and it's just an easy touchdown to Stephon Diggs. I think there's just way too many scenarios where Stephon is going to score a touchdown in this game. The total, I think, is at 46.5, so they're predicting at least 6 touchdowns. I think that it's pretty easy to predict that Stephon Diggs is one of those 6.
I'd say so, too. And Stephon Diggs, he definitely complains when he doesn't get the ball, as we all know. So,
well, he should, because he's, like, the best player on the field at all times.
Yeah.
So.
I love Stephon Diggs anytime touchdown score, because he's never like a Christian McCaffrey minus 200. You're going to get good value betting Stephon Diggs to score a touchdown, and this man is hot with his anytime touchdown scores. Okay. Gobbs, who you got for your anytime touchdown score this week?
Yeah, so after starting 2-0, I've missed the last 2 weeks, so I'm 2-2. So I'm going to change it up, do something I think we haven't really been doing. I'm going to show some love to the tight end position. I've got TJ Hockenson against the Bears. You got Justin Jefferson to the IR. So top weapon is out. The Bears, 31st defense against the pass. They've allowed tight ends to score in 2 of their past 3 games. And as a Lions fan, I've seen a lot of TJ Hockenson, and he seems to just eat when the game is an absolute barn burner. And what's more of a barn burner than the absolute toilet bowl of the NFC North? TJ Hockenson is scoring a touchdown this week. I might even take him to score the first touchdown. Book it.
Cobbs, you do love tight ends scoring touchdowns, particularly the first touchdown. I really like TJ Hockenson. I didn't even think about that until you said it. But that, dude, that just sounds like such a lock with that matchup and Justin Jefferson out. TJ Hockenson is absolutely scoring a touchdown. I think you're right.
Yeah, they don't trust the running backs either because they keep fumbling. So goal line, they're throwing to the tight end, automatic.
Love that. Okay, we're feeling hot so far on these anytime touchdown scores. We've got 2 winners, and this is going to be a 3rd winner this week. I am going with Bijan Robinson, anytime touchdown score. So he scored last week. This is a Commanders team, again, like they get the ball run all over them, and the Falcons at home are just a different team. They're going to be feeding Bijan Robinson the ball, and I think they still, like Desmond Ridder, he finds ways to win at home. I don't think he's a great passer yet. They're going to depend on crazy shovel passes to Bijan Robinson, where you're going to get that cool angle from the sky where they follow him all around. I know we've seen that on Twitter. I don't know why they only do that for Bijan Robinson, but
it's his contract.
Yeah, I bet it is. Yeah. Yeah. And you can book there being another one after week 6 of Bijan Robinson getting into the end zone. I like Bijan Robinson to score a touchdown anytime.
Yeah, I know. And I think I saw this on Twitter. The Commanders this year are currently on pace to give up the most points in NFL history since like the 1980s. So they give up points. And who's going to score points for the Falcons besides Bijan?
Damn right.
I think that is the touchdown score of the week.
Look at us.
I love the pick.
Look at us.
We'll see.
This is not biased. We're not hyping up each other's picks because we think that's what we should do. But I love Stephon Diggs to score a touchdown. I think that's absolutely foolproof. TJ Hockenson is so sharp. I don't think anybody has that on their radar. And Bijan Robinson speaks for itself. We got Propalicious with our anytime touchdown scores. Clark, you're hot with the anytime touchdown scores. Jacobs and I, the last 2 weeks, we were 3-0 on our Like It, Love It, Lock It Ins. 6-0 combined, 12-0 in our last 2 weeks. And we definitely maybe know what we're talking about here, but we definitely maybe thank you for watching the show and for liking and for subscribing. And I think that makes up for a great episode 1.6, boys. What do you think?
Yeah, thanks for locking it in.
All right. Well, thank you for tuning in to episode 1.6 of Lock It In, presented by All Day Media. Catch us next Friday for 1.7. Lock It In. But with you and me, God, man, it feels so intense. I already seen that movie, but I will go again with you. I got a few I've been tending to, but tonight I forgot all about them.